watched John Wick 2, the end of it, and we're about to go see John Wick 3. To me, the end of the second one is a lot like the end of the fucking Dark Knight, alright? And watching the end of it before I went to go see Dark Knight Rises had me all hyped up, like, oh my god, what the fuck is that? And then I was really fucking disappointed with Dark Knight Rises. So, I'm hoping that John Wick 3 sticks landing on this. I don't know, man. I mean, I don't know. I was all excited about it. But, you know, all of a sudden, there's not one bad review. That worries me. I feel like John Wick's not doing his job. If he doesn't piss somebody off. Alright, we just got out of John Wick 3. And, what'd you think?
What did everybody else say? The action was good.
Yeah, the action was great.
That's all you got. There's no explanations.
Yeah.
No.
The story element's not there.
Yes, it's losing the story.
You know, yeah, like, what happened to the impossible task flashback, you know, and this being the last John Wick movie, and I don't know, man.
Why is Halle Berry such a bad actor? Actress.
I don't know. These are questions. These are answers we may never get. But hear the toolbox in the back again. I don't know. I feel like I just watched a Marvel movie. Of course, I know that, you know, this is my first reaction. I'm gonna watch it again because I feel like I owe John Wick that. Yeah. And I feel like part of this is because of my expectations. You know, I was expecting to see the impossible task, and I was expecting to see John Wick die, you know, or go into legend forever. You know, something along that line. So yeah.
Sneaky ninjas were good.
Yo, yeah, ninja are back. That is the most awesome thing about this fucking movie. The ninja are fucking back. Oh my god. We haven't seen anything this cool since Ninja Assassin. And I was like a fan of the fucking ninja movies back in the 80s as a kid. So, Super Ninja. Awesome Kung Fu movie. Or Five Ninja. Or something. I don't know. It's got a different name every time I find it somewhere. Anyway, okay. So that's what we got on John Wick 3 so far. And we'll do something. We'll do more of a review or whatever later.
And here we go.
We've had time to discuss it. We've had time to think about it. And I know I got a couple of complaints still. I mean, I don't know. I told my girlfriend about it, right? And the more I went to talking about it, it's like, the more I realized this movie didn't resolve shit. Like, everything is exactly the way it was at the end of the second movie. And, you know, he's still excommunicado. Everybody's trying to kill him. He still ain't got his car back. You know, we didn't see the Mustang. Those are my expectations right there. It's like the whole, I wanted to see the fucking flashback. And I kind of feel like, I feel like we got Endgamed here or Harry Potter or where, you know, they kind of, it's like they were going to end it with this one. But then somewhere along the line, decided to make it a two-parter, I guess. So now we're getting John Wick Chapter 3, Part 1. You know? And it's in, yeah, I don't know. But, yeah, I really did kind of feel like it was a Marvel movie. Like, I feel like that whole reveal, you know what? I kind of feel like this whole movie was just to get us to the point where Lawrence Fishburne was going to team up with John Wick. Like, that's all this movie did. That is all this fucking movie did, you know? And they pulled that straight-up Marvel move, man, where he was dead.
Yeah, I wouldn't have been surprised if there was an after-credit sequence.
Exactly. I told him, I was like, I'm going to sit through these credits, and I swear to God, if there's a fucking after-credit scene, I'm throwing my cup at the screen, you know? But thank God it wasn't. So, there you go. I didn't have to catch a charge today.
Yeah, the story did make a big loop. Nothing was resolved.
Mm.
The whole trip to the desert, unnecessary.
I know, right? CGI'd to fuck out. Like,
a simple phone call would have sufficed.
Yeah. A simple phone call would have sufficed.
But there are some good points too, like the ninjas.
Oh yeah, like, fucking ninja. Yeah, ninjas are awesome.
Even when I was looking for them, they still caught me off guard.
Yeah, motherfuckers just coming out of the fucking woodworks. That was fucking awesome. I love that shit.
And the dogs. I really enjoyed the dogs.
Yeah, dogs were cool. They got some good play time. I think some people were disappointed they weren't in the movie enough, you know, but I felt like they had just the right amount of time. So,
I could do with more of them and less Halle Berry.
Yeah, no shit, right? Halle Berry pulled an X3 on us.
That's what I was saying. Like, she just didn't sell it for me.
I know, right?
And the emotion wasn't in it.
Yeah, I know. And that's just Halle Berry now. Anyway.
What about the time thing? The hour turning into two? I think we have to do some more research on that one.
We did. Yeah, that's kind of like a little petty thing that's bothering me now, because we went back to two. All right, we went back to the end of two because it threw me off. It's like, wait a minute. It was daytime when we left, and I thought it was a different time or some shit. So we went back and watched it, and there is kind of an hour discrepancy where, you know, it's 4 o'clock whenever he's like, all right, you got 1 hour, all right? And then, you know, he calls the people, they said it, and then they call everybody and let them know, hey, in 1 hour, John Wick's ass is open, all right? Spread cheeks and all right? No lubricant at all. And you're like, oh, fuck, it's starting. And then and then John Wick 3 starts, and it's dark, and it's nighttime, it's raining, which, okay. But then, all of a sudden, they change. It's like they just erased the end of 2. Because now, I know it's only 1 hour. It's like, instead of 5 o'clock, it's 6 o'clock now. And then they wait to send the phone calls out to everybody. Something they already did at the end of 2. Alright? And, I don't know. I'm really getting into this one, because this is probably the first review we're doing fresh. You know, the end game one was a couple of weeks late, and, you know, who gave a shit about that anyway. But John Wick 3, I've been passionate about, you know. I've been really I had high expectations. I tried to go in like I normally do, you know, where I just, like, no expectations, or this is going to be a shitty movie. And so I'm surprised, you know, if it is shitty, then okay. And if it's awesome, then it's like, whoa, you know.
It was really back and forth for me, but I think I want to watch it again.
I am definitely. I mean, I'm going to buy it. I'm getting it on Blu-ray. But so
I feel like it was a good action movie.
It was. Yeah, I guess. You know. But it was
tight. Some of it threw me off a little bit. Like I was saying, at some point I felt like people were just throwing themselves into walls.
Yeah. You know.
I didn't feel like there was power behind it, you know.
Exactly. Like, I don't know. I guess watching 1 and 2 recently kind of had our expectations up on that. And I don't know. It's like, am I the asshole? Because everybody loves this movie. Everybody's like, oh, the action's awesome. Blah. But honestly, like I said, I don't know if I said this or not, but after that first initial act of him getting out of New York City, fucking everything kind of goes downhill from there, you know? And I really do feel like an asshole saying this, because I'm like the only fucking person on YouTube who's probably got a negative thing to say about this movie. But, so yeah, here I am, unpopular opinion guy, putting his balls on the block. And, yeah.
All we can do now is wait and see where it goes from here.
That's right. So, alright, well, thanks for listening. Thanks for noticing. This has been the Working Man Reviews with Guts and Shadow Vessel. Thanks for watching. What's up, everybody? I'm gonna make it short, because I think I've went on long enough about this, and this is way overdue, I know that, but here I am. Finally, I got the Blu-ray. I've watched it a few times since I got it, and I think I see what they're doing now. And here is kind of my problem, and the reason why I feel like it's kind of okay, you know, it's cool now, you know. But to me, John Wick 3 really wasn't a John Wick movie per se. Hang in here with me. If anybody's ever read the Kick-Ass 2 prelude, the prelude to Kick-Ass 2, the Hit Girl one-shot they did, you'll know what I'm talking about. I don't know, it's like, now I get it. It feels like this is a bridge between 2 and the real 3, if that makes any sense. It's like, I don't know, maybe he came up with a story that he wanted to do, but there was some other stuff that he needed to do first to get that added up. I don't know. But now I know I can watch it, and, you know, I'm hoping to see, I'm going to see the next one. I'm not going in with any more expectations, that's for damn sure. But, yeah, this movie is definitely, you know, it's, honestly, I'd like to make a fan edit. I'd like to just make the whole thing about Manhattan. Cut out the whole Casablanca trip into the desert, and yeah, it would suck. It's gonna suck losing the dogs, but really, story wise, just because I think it's so much cooler if John Wick leaves Manhattan. All right, we know he got out, we know he was going somewhere to try to get something done. All right, you got all this other stuff going on in Manhattan while he's gone, okay, and then cut to at the end when you see him getting off that subway train, suited up, finger missing, you're just like, what the fuck is going on? And it adds an air of mystery, I think. You know, I think they over-explained a little too much in this movie. And for anybody out there who's like, it's a John Wick movie, it's an action movie, it's not supposed to be about story, and I beg to differ. Just because 1 and 2 had solid story, in my opinion. And I was disappointed they didn't carry that over with this one. But now, you know, yeah, I can look forward to John Wick 4, hoping, fingers crossed. So, I've been I'm Shadow Vessel. This has been Working Man Reviews. And if you watched this long, thank you. Hang in there. Thanks for hanging in there. And see you on the next one.
Check out time.